Right. Not at all.
Okay, we are recording. So, Epic, since you're not playing super hot, if you would. And, Alexander, if you want to start putting time towards learning one of the rituals, write down in your inventory which one you have started to learn. Sure. And, put half a night towards that. We are not gonna penny and dime this any more than half nights, essentially. Because that's just a pain in the dick.
And my character's just going to go around the mansion and see if there's anything else that might screw us over in the mansion itself. Weaknesses, that kind of shit.
Okay.
I found one already.
You can make another roll at, I think, 9 plus 2, since this is very, very vaguely tied to the thing. And, Jackalore, you may add a, I think, how many did he kill? Because the jog passed out, but he probably would have died. He killed the grandma, he killed the bus driver, he... And that's it, I think.
Yeah, so I think that's actually it. That's all he described killing.
No, actually, he said he would have finished off the jocks.
I did say I killed the jock.
I thought he said that after he left, but if you want to go with that, sure.
It's fine. He can add three more civvy humans to that to keep it current. And keep your kill lists up to date.
Of course.
I actually haven't put the kill list up yet. I have my... I call it a vinculum? Why do I call it vinculum? Stupid.
Okay, so, yeah, 9 plus 2 to learn something about the walls as they try to whisper to you. Well, that would be 9 plus 1 for you. Given how you've been rolling, I think you can succeed at that.
Possibly, but I'll actually go ahead and spend a willpower point on this. It seems pretty important to me.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm putting my kill rating up.
I'm wondering if insight would apply for this, but unless it's something that's actually a vampire, would it?
It is actually very specifically about vampires.
Then no. No.
If you want, you could include two different roles, one for vampire stuff and one for regular.
No. No.
Okay.
Let's just see how well you do.
Alright. Let's see.
Okay.
I did spend one, but it didn't do anything.
Yes. How does that work with 9 plus successes required? Does that still count as a botch with the willpower point spent?
It normally doesn't, but...
Okay, I'm not gonna fuck you on that. Yeah, the wall tries to get your attention, but you realize that walls are unimportant in the grand scheme of things, and it doesn't get to talk to you.
Yep. I'm glad I did that.
It's a good thing you did.
Didn't get anything from it, didn't lose anything from it. It's good.
Yes. Because if you had botched, I might have said something along the lines, yes, the gates. If you have the gates, someone will lock them against you when there's a fire, and you'll die in there.
We will never have gates. good thing we did that. Good. Need a minus one from the thing.
Okay. So if... does anyone have anything else you would like to do on this night?
John would like to find a nice place to put people and bodies. Yeah.
Essentially a dumping ground.
Yes.
Well,
the dumping ground.
You can always just dump out the old, musty, 200-year-old skeletons, which are clearly worthless, and bury fresh bodies in the graves.
Yeah, he can do that.
Then again...
his work.
Then again, perhaps dropping them in the lake or the river might be better as in not having them at a mansion.
Dimension is here, right?
Yep.
What is the road to connect to dimension? This one?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, I could drop the body near here. Just go this third floor road.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that might well work, and there's not that much down there that would probably detect them. Probably. I'm sure it wouldn't be a problem with the cops coming after you.
Mm-hmm. And after, you know, surveying the grounds, it's time to hunt.
Okay.
Hunt down the...
This would be the middle of the night. What would be the base difficulty for essentially what is a commercial district be at this time of night?
I figure a 9.
Yes, 9 most likely because...
Did we have domain?
We do have domain.
So I'm wondering, because it's a really crappy location in a lot of ways, but... Raising it above 9 seems way too dickish, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? Let's go with 9. This town is a good place. People aren't afraid to enjoy the night air. We have established that it's essentially break in the universities, right? So, people are enjoying the starlight, walking around. You can find someone.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Let's see, where is the...
If you're... You know, I'll give you 2 options. You can use either Dexterity Stealth to creep up on someone, or you can use Wit Stealth and decrease the difficulty by a further 1 for having obfuscate. So that would essentially entail you waiting in ambush for in a likely place and grabbing them when they go by.
Why would I do that?
I don't know.
Is there a reason I can't go talk to people? We need to have a heart-to-heart about the animals, the farming community.
Your own conviction and instinct, they would almost immediately sense that you're a monster, according to description. Even an oblivious fat candy lady figured it out pretty quickly. More so since you're low on your path, which...
You know, I have a question. Would it have given me humanity for killing such a monstrous being?
Sorry, what?
The fat candy lady.
No.
Humanity isn't about killing you, monster. Clearly, there is nothing in you that is humane left.
Well, no shit.
Gamers, okay, they're
so
the
worst.
So
you're saying that I basically do have to... ambush people.
I'm saying that...
And that social interaction is completely invalid regardless?
No, but I will add to the difficulty because you have to be good enough at it that you distract from the fact that you feel like a monster. Right? You have to actually balance that out as well with your skill. Because apparently, according to the book, people are supposed to feel that sort of shit.
No, I know that. It's just that you never did that before for anyone else. So I was just kind of like, that was kind of left fieldy. But sure.
This is the first time any of you are actually hunting, and with Alexander, it was. Well. There was no point in adding difficulties to his, because he was going to fail anyway, and we all knew it. And I wanted to give him some sort of chance to not get shot.
As I said, a little left fieldy, but yeah, that is how the book does it, and all that.
Yeah, I think pretty much all of you would have that problem, right?
That invalidates most of my stuff, yeah.
John. No, John apparently still has self-control, so he's not quite as horrible, in theory.
That's not what it's based on, though.
Oh, right, that was entirely on conscience?
No, it's not on any of that. It's off of your path.
Yes.
Which is why I said it's out from left field, because you never did it for anyone in the Tremere stuff, so...
Oh, right. Well... It states here under the alternative virtues that if you don't... If you have traded away for, essentially, instinct and conviction, then it starts to, that I start to feel it. That's what I was going off of. Because, yeah, we didn't use the path modifiers for being low in humanity. It's true, but they still had a rating in conscience and self-control. Which is why this seems worse, because you have gone beyond just being low on humanity to being completely inhumane and come out on the other side.
Ah, so I'm just kind of screwed both ways. Okay. Damn.
Conviction is completely inhuman. The character who has this trait can no longer pass for human under anything but the most cursory of scrutiny. Creatures who can sense the beast immediately recognize someone with the conviction virtue for what he truly is, a monster. Which implies that mortals, while not immediately being aware of it with an extended conversation, can do pick off as something being really, really off.
Yeah, okay.
So yeah, it's not this bearing modifier so much as the fact that your actual virtues are fucking gone.
Yeah, I think I'm the only one following a path that switched both of them to...
Me actually too.
Oh, you did too?
Yeah.
Yes.
Monsters.
The most humane.
You are not humane. You have self-control, but you're not humane.
Yeah, that sucks.
And also, under the path of, what was it, honor or whatever, they did specify that if you're a path follower, you will pass as inhumane if someone actually checks.
That really sucks. That really eliminated whatever use this character had for trying to be social with humans.
I will simply add some to the difficulty. And, but yeah, that's part of the problem of being Sabbat. And let me think. How would I do it? I wouldn't add more than 2 to the difficulty, essentially. I would let you try to hide it with subterfuge.
That sucks. Well, this chronicle is going to end pretty quick, I think, then. Damn.
Alright, let's think about this. How can we set this up in a way that doesn't completely screw everyone? Because I had some of the same problem with the other pack, where I had to think really carefully how not to completely fuck them.
I didn't think that switching your virtues would literally make you impossible to socialize with.
Yeah, that's kind of a problem with the paths, is that... Yeah, humans don't really like people with paths.
And yet Sabbat have mostly quite a few people with paths.
Yes.
That is confusing.
It is.
Well, just cause they know that, just cause you feel like monster doesn't have to be a negative, necessarily. If anything, it can even add to your roles to control them through, for example, intimidation.
I have that.
Yes, so essentially, you don't try to make deals with people, you don't try to manipulate them in a nice way. You're just the vampire mafia. You do them favors on occasion, maybe, but you expect a great deal in return, and fuck them if they don't pay up.
Alright, I'm going to mix two things for my hunting, then.
Alright, how do you want to do that?
I will use my ability to judge people, aka tell how they are and that kind of stuff, to try and find somebody that's, you know, not going to immediately run away, but is rather, you know, subservient and that kind of stuff.
Oh, so you want to do the rapey hunting that Malik did with manipulation and intimidation?
Yes. Effectively.
You know, given that you feel like a monster, and that you have obfuscate, you can just roll at that. You can even lower your difficulty by an additional one.
Yay.
You can just go, hey, little girl, as she realized there's someone in the shadows.
Oh, not only that, I should be able to identify when people, you know, when I don't have to chase them down. They'll be too much in terror. Yay, good judge of character.
Unless you botch, that is certainly going to be a thing, yes. And it should be a difficulty 5 roll.
Alright.
Does that thing take in consideration our domain?
Yes, it does.
Okay.
You have essentially a farmer's market. Getting a 5 is great. Do you want to leave any of them alive, or are you perhaps going to bring John home a toy?
Oh, nope. I am not killing any of them.
Pussy?
Really?
There's a good reason I don't drain somebody dry.
Oh, you picked that one.
Oh, yes. I believe you have to roll for that,
yes.
Don't you?
Yes.
Okay.
One.
I believe that with 3 victims, you have to roll several times. Botch one, please.
3.
Fuck. You do know that...
it's wonderful. I feel them bubbling inside.
Yes, I know what you flaw you picked.
Epic. If you ever fail at this, and this is gonna make you want to fail it, I believe, you're gonna run through the city using the 4th dot of your dementation.
It depends on the person, but that is very, very possible. And yes, I would love it.
Just straight across the bridge into the city center. Oh, you're the sovereign who's keeping an eye on us! Run, little rabbit!
Get the entire opposing pack killed and set the boss free.
And you know what's awesome? You know what's really awesome? Malkavian stuff isn't very easy to detect, even by vampires. I don't know why! Everyone just started going crazy!
Mm-hmm. Well, go ahead and refill your thing.
Ding. Blood pool for the win. Oh, I actually forgot. We have hunting. Herd. I should have got 3 more dots on that. Whatever. I got more than
a... Herd. Herd acts as a passive income of essentially... it says how many vessels is 3 dots of herd supposed to give you?
15.
Okay, so you can have essentially... After you make contact with the butcher guy, have the drained blood just delivered to you each night at a rate of 15 per night. Just barrels and barrels of cow blood.
Okay, that's awesome, actually. I love this.
You know, it's a good thing my character doesn't care about the quality of blood.
Neither does mine, to be honest. He does like the bubbly feeling, though.
Instead of the one that makes you feel like moo.
To be fair, moo is good every once in a while. But is better.
But yeah, I'm not gonna let you stockpile that unless you actually take the time to spin it into those Vita infusion things.
Yeah.
Because it will spoil, especially that's the day's take. It's already, it's essentially bad come next morning.
Essentially, we just don't really have to hunt in general.
That's a good thing.
Yep.
Yeah. So how many dots did we pick in the...
333. We went over this.
Yes.
Okay. So, domain, herd, and... What was the third one?
Security.
Oh, yeah. Security. Okay. Thank
security
you.
For domain. You have 6 in domain, 3 in herd.
This isn't including the location, by the way. It is basically impossible for others to hunt in our domain.
Actually, yes, given how bad it is and how easy it is to keep an eye on it, I would say that it would come to you through the butcher eventually, that you would be able to... Well, you know how we're going to spin this. We're going to say that they can't hunt without you knowing about it. Because, yeah...
They can't hunt without us knowing. Yeah, I feel that's actually the bigger part of security.
Yeah, essentially that plus 3 is implied if you want to do it secretly.
Mm-hmm.
And I would prefer for there to eventually be a ghoul at least watching the bridge, or at least there to be a secret camera on the bridges to watch for vampire-looking types. Just for this make a lot more sense, because... Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is
just the intro. Again, this is just to show us getting integrated into the city a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm presuming the next one's going to be starting in like at least a couple of days after we've set everything up.
Well, it depends on how you want to do it, actually. I can go with either way. As far as I'm concerned, this can be the first real actual session.
It's up to you guys.
Don't care, really. Also, I'll be using Wake with Evening's Freshness before I go to sleep.
Just say that you do that every night.
Yes, I will be doing that every night.
Yay!
I'm tempted. I'm so tempted to make you say it every time and fuck you when you forget.
It's up to you, man. Just make sure you forewarn him in this case, because... you don't get to say you do it every time. You have to say it every time.
Unless you specifically say it, it will be an intelligence roll to see if you remember that night, and if you are able to find the feather or whatever it is that you need in time.
Ashes of feathers. Doesn't specify what kind of feathers. I can essentially take feathers.
Yes, but you do have to burn it over the place you sleep.
Yes. And no, I won't be doing it inside the library.
I wasn't gonna suggest you were.
Sure you wouldn't.
I love how he's paranoid about the smallest things. I think he's learning, Epic. I think he's actually learning.
Maybe. Alright, so on the next day,
you may
then gather everyone together. We need to begin the acceptance rites now.
Yep. There is a beep, beep from outside. There is a truck with a cow, cartoonish cow, sticking out its tongue with a goofy smile on its face, waiting there.
Darnell, take care of that.
Yes, master.
So, were you two already in the pack before, or do we have to do this for everyone?
I was in that pack before.
This pack.
You would know each other from before, I would say. I think. But it's up to you. If you want to say that you're from entirely different packs, that's okay too.
Don't really care. Though considering how I introduced myself to everyone, I guess I probably wouldn't have been in the same pack.
Okay.
In that case, we'll just have to do this 3 times. He brings out you know what? He just brings out a bucket. It's a metal one. So
where did you put the non-GM roll?
It's in the thing. It should be visible to you.
Nope.
It's not.
I
go under the gear and click the show in bar thing.
Yes. There's the GM role. There's something under name. It says GM role. I don't know why it just says GM role, but it's weird.
Cause that's what I named it.
That's for rolling to the GM, you know?
Oh, the ordinary one isn't. Crap, okay. That should be better.
Thank you.
Okay, Darnell, you hear a thud from outside and a knock on the door. Could someone get this for me? I'm carrying the barrel.
Who are you asking this of?
He's just calling inside, just in general. Could someone get the door, please? I'm carrying the barrel.
Marches over to the door, opens it. What's out there?
It's Darnell. There are two barrels there. He's hefting one, looking very red in the face, but somehow managing to carry it with his ghoul strength.
Shut up! We're busy here!
Slam!
Alright, let's continue.
I don't care. Darnell can handle himself.
Darnell's eyes narrow. His skin starts to ripple as he takes war form. Gaia demands your blood, abomination.
You know I'm gonna. You know what? Just tell me his nature. I'll get it eventually anyway. And I'm just going to get anyone's nature that's relatively nearby. So whatever.
Okay, roll for it. If you botch, I want to see if you manage to botch. And he's not a vampire, so there's a chance.
There is a chance.
But apparently not this time. You see a shadow behind Darnell's. He seems to be bowed beneath the weight of the things he's done and forced to be a part of.
So he's a bitch. Alright.
He's a penitent, so yes. Pretty much.
Makes sense.
Maybe I should actually start writing down people's natures. I just don't give enough of a shit right now, though.
No, don't write them down. Satan wouldn't.
That's right. Satan doesn't. He won't. He'll forget them. Have to roll again.
Could you get the door?
All right, so let's continue.
I have blood!
He now, and this time, he pulls out a hammer.
Just remember to take down the blood for tonight.
Yep. Alright, so, any opposing in which I, greetings, shall be accepted into this pack?
No, I do not oppose it.
Raise of thumbs.
Raise my thumb.
Up or down?
Up. That's why you raise it.
Alright. Here, take this hammer and smash that thumb into little bits and throw it into the pot.
Sigh and attempt to do it.
Okay, would you like to spend a willpower point to inflict deliberate self-harm of this magnitude on your poor thumb?
Actually, do I have to roll a cult to know that this is not the way, or it is the way you're supposed to do it?
If you don't have at least one dot in rituals, I would say that you wouldn't have the background to roll a cult for it, probably.
Seriously?
All that's generally known is that what the priest says is true.
I look at greetings and say, you sure?
Yes.
Darnell, meanwhile, is slowly wheeling the barrel inside. Actually, no, he's kicking one of them while carrying the other on his back.
It follows his nature really well, actually, so go ahead.
Master, I've brought dinner.
Yes, leave it here in the room and leave us alone.
Sorry, Master, I'll leave right away, Master. Backs out, trips, runs.
Well, go ahead. What's taking so long?
These are the hands of a scholar you don't understand!
Are you completely sure it's necessary to do the cut? What are you fucking doing?
Dude, this is completely legit, and it's not even that weird.
You know, I think you have a dud, Doctus, here. I think you have a dud.
The stealth rictus that's recommended is to eat each other's tongues out. So, yeah.
Curse
the hammer into your fucking hand.
Do it! Do it now!
Sorry about that. I was interrupted. Most rudely.
Make sure to swing hard to shatter the bone.
I said he has to smash the thumb off to get into the pot. So,
exactly, so swing hard to get through the bone.
Do note that usually during these rituals, they do not actually cost anything besides maybe blood points.
I would say that regrowing a thumb would be a lethal point of damage, and that's one blood point, I think.
I think that's actually how they justify it.
Much like getting shot in the eye would. Apply the appropriate flow until you heal the lethal damage points involved.
So I just take a point of damage, essentially.
Mm-hmm. No. You have to force it, because that's not going to happen automatically. That's against self-preservation. A lot of things...
I need wrong perception empathy to see if he's being completely serious. Going to increase or decrease the difficulty in
no,
any way?
No, it's as tempting as it is to help ensure that you botch, I think Lady Luck is breathing down my neck, not yours. So go for it. I feel a botch coming. Well, fuck you, you whore.
You felt it. You felt the ones. You didn't sense the tens.
Wait, what? Is that Nietzsche? No, that's just a random noise from Skype. Huh, weird.
So,
Greetings is deadly serious, and he's getting angry that you're not following the rituals as you're supposed to.
I do it.
So how do we want to do this? Do we just make him spend willpower point, or are we generous and let him roll at 9? Well, it's not fire, so I guess we could make it, let him roll.
Letting him roll seems alright, but I really feel that this really isn't that big of a one compared to the rituals they recommend.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But it is very brutal and very painful, so let's go with the willpower roll at 9.
Just to keep going through it. Don't
yes.
botch, you'll piss the duck, you'll piss the priest off.
If you botch, you'll look like a wimp. Woo. Okay, how much do you have in strength?
1.
Okay, and 4 in stamina. Greetings, you watch him hammer helplessly on the finger, and it just refuses to die.
It will eventually go. There's no way it won't. If he just is able to keep hammering on it.
How much damage is a hammer?
+1, probably.
Then... I would say that it would be a...
Does it have a sharp, the sharp side, which you use to pry
yes.
it off?
Yes, it does.
Okay, so it'd be lethal.
Okay, fine. I suppose.
The Sabbat Rite have to be possible, otherwise it's useless.
Mm-hmm. Alright. So why don't you roll me a dex melee at 9 to hit the small ass finger, or see if you manage to hit someone or something else.
He already did the willpower, and it's very simple. No.
Oh, come on.
I'm not letting you get away with this. Nope.
Seriously. It's a fucking right. They're supposed to be able to be doable, at least.
Not only doable, but done all the fucking time.
Okay. Yes. Fine. He hammers on the finger for half an hour as it slowly, slowly flattens.
There! Now you're getting into the spirit.
I then put dirt into the fire. And heal my wound.
You're gonna have to do this 2 more times. You're gonna lose half of the night on this kind of crap.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Although, to be fair, it won't be him for one of them. He'll do it one more time.
Okay, fine.
Okay, and you! John, do you accept me as priest of this pact?
Yeah. It's nice to see that you're not totally crazy like most of the Mokavians.
Take this hammer and smash that thumb off.
Throw it you know, the proper answer there, John, was no! Grow claws. Activates alert the actions. But I guess you just don't get it.
Hey, if he goes, if he actually goes against those tenants, he gets to roll.
So, willpower to smash the finger?
Roll willpower, and this is just to see how much of a pansy you are or not.
Yep. At 9.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can spend a willpower point and just smash through it.
You shouldn't spend a willpower point here.
No?
Otherwise, you'd be spending willpower points on every ritual, and we have a lot.
Yeah, there's a lot of them.
Go on, drain your willpower. I want what I had in Springfield.
Just accept looking like a pansy if that was what happens. Good job.
You know?
Oh, no, I don't.
In comparison, Alexander looked like a pansy because John is able to relatively swiftly and efficiently smash the finger to a pulp.
Spend a blood point, did that one. And thus, I am now accepted as Pack Priest. And now, we have one Alexander Turner here for Ductus. Raise of thumbs on who accepts or denies him as Ductus.
I turn towards John. Do you accept me as Ductus?
Yeah, fuck you, bitch. Right?
Yeah, fuck it. I don't care who he is.
Now take the sacred hammer and...
You hear a faint sound from the door.
Can I actually tell what that sound was? Roll for that.
If you wish, you can roll perception alertness.
Sure.
I'll be rolling perception alertness.
Okay. Jekyll, are you... Definitely heard the sound, but you're not able to figure out what it was exactly. Are you gonna roll, John, by the way?
No. It doesn't even matter for me.
Okay. Greetings. In that case, you're pretty sure that a ghoul is listening in on this.
One moment.
Excuse me, I have to put the children to bed.
I have to put the children to bed. Hello.
Gulp. Shall I lay out the blood?
Don't disturb us. Also, if you wish to see the secrets of things, or hear them, you should go ahead and, you know, get along with everything. And the haunting on the ghoul.
In what?
In the ears.
Okay, roll for it.
Difficulty?
What is the difficulty based on?
That one was with self-control, I think. Let me double check. Dementation, come here. Haunting. Difficulty victims, perception plus self-control.
Okay, just roll at the base and I'll write down how fucked he is.
And remember, minus one.
Uh-huh. Alright.
I think he's fucked.
Yeah, yeah, that seems likely, doesn't it? You see him swallow, and then just his head snaps around. He starts backing away and just vanishes around the corner.
Have fun! Alright, let's continue. Now,
writing down as hearing shit forever.
Show so, look everything sensei. I like you. You scare mortals like a real man does.
So John goes and hacks off his thumb again.
Yeah, hack off the thumb again. Although this time I get to do it too. Let's see how pansy ass I look.
Can't even carry out his own rituals.
Ah, I can't carry it out. Ah.
Do I need to roll again just spend blood?
You do need to roll again, yes. And greetings. You know, I'm not gonna let you try that again this night with the botch. On a fail, sure, but you just can't bring yourself to do it when it's your turn. It's your thumb! You need that for gripping things and shit!
I need this to suck!
So, you know, with or without, you are managing to suck at the moment, so that is a factual statement, possibly, but not entirely accurate.
Well, the end result is true, but his arguments may be wrong.
Even John seems to have trouble with this. Perhaps they are not entirely confident in Alexander's leadership.
Dude, you're putting on difficulty 9 willpower thing on common rights and stuff. Whatever.
Ah, true enough. Then again, self-harm in other places is described as a thing.
Yeah, but what would be the role to see about eating each other's tongues out?
I'd make that something similar as well. Probably. I wouldn't make it worse than this. And frankly, the way I see it, smashing your thumb systematically with a hammer seems like a pretty drawn-out thing, whereas just biting off a tongue is relatively quick and painless in comparison. So I would probably actually make that a lot easier.
Kissing somebody and then eating their tongue, right? That's a thing.
True, true. But even so, I would say that actually forcing yourself to hurt yourself is like that, deliberately, systematically, over a prolonged period.
Which
I would consider that.
How I decided to do this, actually. Because if anyone had said no and did the thumbs down, it was the honor of the person who was, you know, being the leader to smash their thumb off. That's how I decided to do the acceptance rites.
All right.
So he's refusing to cut off. You're refusing to cut off your thumb.
I can't, which actually means that in this case, it's your job. I can't do it. Take it. Do it yourself.
Okay, I take the thumb. Also, I won't be spending anything. I'll be rolling, and I'll be attempting to cut off his thumb.
Not cut off the tongue. Smash the thumb.
Smashing the thumb.
Okay.
This means I'm going to be trying to struggle out, by the way, because I botched.
Yay. So,
don't worry. One strength. Versus one strength.
You know,
Like, what?
I am okay with that being just a, just ignoring the damage thing, but, do launch me a couple of attack rolls. Since you're holding it down, we'll make it a 7, I think.
Alright. Let's see how well you do.
But yeah, the tongue thing, that is actually in comparison, I honestly think that that would be easier.
Really?
In the terms of forcing yourself to do it, because it's quick, right? And you don't have to do it yourself, right? I don't know, just something about grinding your thumb into a paste with a hammer.
Does that work?
Yes, that works very much so. You turn it to pulp.
I like it as an acceptance rite, I'll be honest. I thought it was a really cool idea.
And honestly, if you do it like this every time, it kind of adds significance to it if there is the chance of people pussing out like this. I honestly think that that adds some, you know, significance to it.
Sure.
I mean, it's not like it's huge damage, but it's gruesome.
To accept people into the pack. That, and I thought it was a good one.
It works.
And a Malkavian-ish way.
It works just fine. But yeah, the this is when you accept new members, right? That's a relatively rare thing. The more everyday things, I certainly wouldn't make this difficult anyway. And I honestly think that most of them, as described, wouldn't have to be that difficult. And another point is that I prefer to go off the way you describe it.
Okay. And I was just surprised at the difficulty 9 part.
Yeah. I don't know, it just strikes me as a really gruesome way in terms of having to actually force yourself to do it to yourself.
Mm-hmm. Which is why I thought it was a great acceptance rite.
Yeah.
Either you do it yourself, or you pansy out, and have to have the one that is being accepted do it.
I'll take my acceptance from you.
Exactly.
Okay. So I believe that greetings has been mutilated sufficiently.
Yes.
You may proceed.
Just throw it in the fire.
I do throw it in the fire.
Heal it up. Ding.
You hear a faint, "Why won't the voices stop? Leave me alone!" in the distance. You're gonna have a mad Igor by the time it's done. You know you will.
Yes, we will.
Yes, we will. Now all we need is vicissitude.
I have actually been wondering, by the way, is there a way I can cancel out certain things? A lot of the Malkavian stuff lasts just a super long time, but that's the only thing it does.
Cancel out the Malkavian powers you cast yourself.
Yes, myself, not other people.
When you're casting it, I would let you spend a willpower point to essentially pull the blow once you realize it's a lot stronger than you wanted it to be. Essentially, if you spend willpower point, you can cap the amount of damage you deal. Much like with physical attacks we ruled on a few occasions in Springfield. But that would obviously be at the cost of a willpower point.
As I get it, and at the same time, I don't like it.
Well, if you open the gates of madness, you know, I would let you roll with fewer dice, I guess. That could be workable, but you would know how well you would succeed beforehand, so it gets iffy.
Yeah.
The willpower thing would be good for the situations where you need to get, for example, exactly 2 successes.
I was thinking more because the first dot of the Malkavian stuff can be an awesome way to support a party and debuff for other people. So, but it's very permanent if I get 6+ successes.
Well, I'll think about it.
That's specifically what I'm thinking about.
I'll think about it.
Yeah.
I would have to, maybe if you spend a turn before concentrating and then decided to aim for a specific amount of successes, that could work. But there would need to be some sort of a limiting factor on it, obviously.
Yeah, okay.
I just wanted to know if that was possible, because I've always thought that being able to enhance and or limit the emotions of the party members could be a really big boon.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you may proceed with the roleplay. Oh, or yes. Are you not gonna accept John? I never liked that guy anyway. Fuck him.
And now John, who is coming in as a new member of the pack. Who here accepts or denies his place here?
I accept his place here.
Greetings puts his thumb up too. Time to roll for both of us.
Yep.
You know,
Satan managed to do it.
I did mean with the boss that you couldn't try it again for the rest.
It doesn't matter, there are four times there.
Oh. I thought it was for. Oh, okay.
For the night, essentially. So. I do believe.
I guess he just does it himself then.
Yes. Bacon?
Smash his thumb! You can smash it! Now everyone knows that the Ductus is a pansy ass.
What?
Like, he's a Malkavian, so, hey.
Not the Ductus, the priest. Bacon, are you there?
Oh yeah, the priest. Ugh.
Have you vanished, Bacon? I think you're muted, Bacon, or possibly not here. Please let us know which...
super hot again.
Bacon! Bacon.
He isn't playing anything.
The fuck is going on? Pokemon Steam, quick everyone, swarm him!
Zergrash.
Bacon! 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 All caps. Bacon, all caps. Several O's. Several exclamation points.
I'm back.
He has risen.
Smash your Ductus's priest into smithereens.
You have the hammer, John. You can smash Greeting's hand. Would you like to aim for the head instead with the sharp bend?
Mm-hmm.
Tempting, isn't it?
Yes.
He would probably succeed as well.
But for some reason I feel like I'm a friend of him. I'm loyal to him somewhat, so I will just aim for the thumb.
In the distance, as John does this, you hear faint scream, "No, mother, I will not take a bath!"
So, do I roll to hit his finger?
Yes.
Yes, roll it.
Possibility of botching and slamming in my head is still a thing.
Well, dexterity, maybe. Yeah. It will be hard to miss.
Make several rolls, unless you do really well on the first one.
Let me see at my celerity.
Oh, yes. No, it's 7, but that's still a success.
Ow!
Alright. Give me another 2 rolls, much like Jack Lord did. Keep in mind, you do have the roll function if you enable the macros in the bar.
There's even a simpler way if you guys really want. If you're making multiple rolls, to the left is a dice roller that includes our last 10 rolls.
Right, this thing! Fuckers.
What?
That's right.
So, his finger is dead, right?
The what?
Yep,
The finger's dead.
Ooh, that one! I have never used the dice roller.
You know, John gets very enthusiastic and he flattens your entire hand into a paste. rips it off at the rice and tosses it into the fire.
That's what you get for being a pansy.
I understand that you enjoy the fingers, but I did not see the art in that.
Go for the kill.
Oh, interesting this dice roller.
I'm presuming minus 3 for regrowing limb.
I'm probably minus 2 because of, you know.
Yeah, it's... That would be for the entire forearm, I think. But 2 sounds appropriate.
Alright. Okay. Acceptance, right? It's done. We are Peck. Do you have a name?
By the way, what's your name 3 months later? Apparently the city is really small. It's like a, you know, one of, like that chessboard in Harry Potter. You're standing on your tiles waiting for your turn to move.
It's 120 feet long.
In the faint distance, you see the mages gathering for the counterattack.
Oh, jeez.
Does Bane Fire Pack work?
Sorry, what?
Bane Fire Pack.
What the fuck is that?
You know, fire from the underworld. Bane Fire.
Does he mean Hellfire?
No, it's not Hellfire. It's different. Bane Fire comes from the...
Is that the Harry Potter thing?
No, it's from Greek mythology.
Oh, you fucker! As if we know mythology!
I know it actually quite well. I'm surprised I didn't hear about Banefire.
I think it's something like that. I can't remember exactly.
It's some
I'll just
cheap...
send you up the sticks, okay?
You know, I think it's some cheap knockoff version of Greek mythology they have up in Finland, so...
What? What?
Clearly, their Greek mythology isn't the same as ours. Let me just place the token on the... thing. Come on. There we go. Let me just set up the giant flesh monster. Don't worry about
flesh monster. Although there is a insight will almost always work on that because it's made from vampire magic, literally. So I'll be able to tell it's there, probably.
Possibly. As you hear knocking from the walls, nah, I'm just fucking with you, it's fine.
I know.
Not tonight. Not
yeah,
yet.
Yeah, not tonight. You know what else is going to probably happen soon?
Do please enlighten us.
You know what, I'll just let it be a surprise. I'll leave it up to you whether or not my character will be able to tell if it's going to happen.
Whisper it to me so I know what you're talking about.
I already did.
Referring to what? Ah, yes. That thing.
Yeah, that thing.
You know, I like this idea. Chuka 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 chuka. You hear the chopper outside? That is a very good point. Apparently someone is circling the manor.
Ah.
I go to a window, look outside.
There is a floodlight focused on the front gate and the bus you left there.
Why would I have... I thought I walked here.
You said no, you said you came in on the bus.
Apparently I did.
You did.
I thought they dumped the bus somewhere.
You didn't say you dumped the bus anywhere.
Unless you specifically say it and make sure that...
I walked to the manor.
You said that after you said you arrived.
Yep, you stopped outside and Jackalore. This is hard mode where I don't hold your hand. You make sure that your, you know, safety nets for avoiding stupid crap like this are registered by the GM, and that he gets that you are not that stupid.
You didn't actually specify when we looked outside that there was a bus outside.
No, he has specified multiple times that the bus is outside.
Like, no, he did not, actually.
Yeah. I did say that you drive up and that you see the pineapple machine. That was how I introduced you arriving, right? You saw the van with fire. We've
looked outside a couple times since. The bus has been there.
No, he did not specify even once that the bus was outside.
Me and Bacon have both heard this multiple times.
Remember the idea of using the bus to fight the Vod?
Yes, the bus is still there in case of Vod attack.
It has been mentioned multiple times, Jackalore.
I swear I didn't hear you once mention that the bus was outside.
Yes, multiple times.
Multiple.
You hear a loudspeaker from outside. The GM mentioned the bus multiple times, we heard him too!
If you're not...
Technically it's SD.
Whatever.
Oh, you're gonna be one of those, are you?
I am in this case.
Well then, you should have specified what did you do with the bus.
So how do you wish to resolve this now that this has gone horribly wrong?
I can't do shit about that.
A pity you weren't a dominate, Tremere, huh? I'm sure with your great social stats you can solve this, right?
Right.
Yes, with all my manipulation subterfuge.
Well, I have a potential solution if you are interested in having a destiny point, and I would say that this has the potential of succeeding.
I would actually say yes for the destiny point here.
I would too, because otherwise we're screwed.
I would say that, greetings, getting close to there, listening to the pilots, if they were to perhaps land and investigate the situation, so that he can pick up the voices, or any cops that came there, he might be able to, with his massive subterfuge, fix said voices and give a false report as to them having found a wrong bus and heading off in a different direction, for example, and then just take out the people who arrived there and have the cops looking for the crashed helicopter and their buddies somewhere entirely else.
I like this a lot. Let's do that.
I do agree as well.
This is...
But if it's alright, because we're using a destiny point, can we skip over some of it? If that's alright.
We can treat this as a cutscene.
Yeah.
Describe what happens. As the cops eventually, after circling a few times, decide that the guy has long since ditched this place, and there's a pilot and two cops in there, and they just land and start investigating the crime scene.
Alright. So, it's up to you, Ductus. Where do you wish for?
If you...
No?
You're good at lying, aren't you?
Yes.
So, could you go there, go out there, convince, go out there, take care of them, and convince the people on the other side that it was the wrong bus, and then we can have John over here, eliminate the cops. And then we can have the helicopter either crash or we can keep it here, depending on if I can find out if there's any tracking system in it.
Uh-huh. Okay. I'm not good at taking care of people, but
that's why we'll have John kill them.
Okay.
Here's a fun fact: since you are using a Destiny get out of jail free card. You have a helicopter and a pilot out there.
Yep.
Just think on
blood
that.
Bonds.
No, I already know. Thing is, my character has an intelligence of 1. He's not going to think of that kind of thing.
Well, after they're dead, you can always turn them.
Not included.
Yeah, we can always turn them.
A helicopter and a couple of sniper rifles isn't a horrible counter to a Vost, in theory.
In theory. So he will be going outside and listening in, and I'll even use my dot of obfuscate to try and stay out of sight.
God, what a monster. You hear all these people. So horrible. Who'd have thunk? Apparently he's some sort of student or something. Looks really young. I know, Jim. No student could have done this. How would you like to proceed?
First, I will now go back really quick and say, "Okay," or some kind of signal of, "Ready, John, come kill people."
Yes.
Wave a red rag.
He's crazy enough. He has a red coat. Puts on a stick.
John goes with stealth to kill the people.
Okay. Who do you go for, to land the chopper or the people in the bus? This is an important decision, perhaps.
Question. Do they have a direct line of sight to the people inside the bus?
The pilot is apparently reading a magazine right now, so... Then again, who knows? It might make too much noise.
Do you note that... Greetings is now trying to stealthily make his way towards the chopper.
Okay.
I will go for the bus. Let me roll my stealth.
You know, since we're rolling, yes. Greetings, go ahead and roll a difficulty for to see if you can sneak up on the pilot without him noticing before John fucks it all up with his crappy ones.
Can I also roll a difficulty for?
No,
they are actually paying attention because they are actively examining the crime scene. The pilot, on the other hand, is distracted. He's just a bus driver. He just drives people here.
I am stealthy like the night.
Okay, you are standing right behind the pilot. You can hear him breathing. You have the drop on him as you see John just stumble slightly over these steps. As he climbs into the bus and the people turn to look at him.
Oh, wow. That turned out terribly over there.
Probably kill him.
Sucks to be him, right?
He'll support you.
He's going to be spending blood points on raising strength now.
Okay.
And I'll just go up to 4, I guess.
Have you been spending your blood points as you are heading over here, or just now?
He's ever since just before getting into the helicopter.
Okay, in that case, you would have had enough time.
And...
Don't ruin the machinery, you might need it.
No, I'm trying to think of how... Can I just go for a kiss right here?
Yes, easily. He's, you have essentially one turn in which he, before he notices anything, at least.
That's the idea.
He takes a dice if he doesn't attack, doesn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Essentially, I'm sure you can succeed at this.
Okay.
It would be a dex brawl at difficulty 3, and under the auto success rules, you can get one success on that automatically.
Okay. Then, yeah, I'm just going to, you know, give him the kiss.
Okay. He does not like making out with dudes, but he doesn't really feel like he has much of a choice given that you backed him in the corner there, so he goes along with it, but it's gonna be quite a walk of shame in the morning.
And I'm going to, you know... I'm going to start using a lot of it to buff, and I'm going to not drain him, but I'm going to basically kill him. That makes sense.
Okay, so essentially you take 6?
Yeah.
Okay, that works. John, as you climb into the bus, you stumble slightly, and the two cops turn to look at you. Sir, this is a... Oh... Dude, remember that this... Yeah, they go for their guns.
Hello, officer. Get me a help.
On the floor, right now! Hands behind your head.
No, this only took like 6 seconds to drain this guy to death. It's great.
He puts his hands behind his head and activates a protein and gets claws.
So you're growing claws with your hands behind your head. Are you getting down on the floor?
No, I just put my hands behind and say, what's happening here, officers?
On the ground, right now.
You do know they're not approaching you, right?
I just say, alright, and I lower myself a little bit and use celerity to rush at them and slice them.
If you want to know what's happening in the meantime in the helicopter, he's looking around, seeing if there's anything decent with, weapons.
I use my 2 celerity.
Okay. I think that given they were prepared for you to try something, because you're clearly on the same shit as that other guy, they would get to shoot you once for each before you manage to obliterate them.
I hope you put something in fortitude.
Yeah, I don't have fortitude.
You said a gangrel.
Yeah.
Oh, crap.
Okay, so... So, I would assume they would know how to shoot, being country cops, and they would have those big magnums, right?
Probably, yeah. In fact, I almost guarantee it.
Okay, so that would be 1 headshot. Have fun with that. And that's the 2nd attack. Again, crappy attack, but good damage. So please, if he fails both of these, he's in torpor, by the way.
I know.
Bang, bang. So much for Sabbat. It bounces off, ricochets, takes out a window. Okay, you take 2 damage, and at that point, you're on the cops. You manage to easily eviscerate them. Their blood is pooling in on the bus's floor, and you can make a necklace out of their entrails. Congratulations, you monster.
I drink their blood. How much can I get?
About 5 from each. They're bleeding profusely. Keep in mind, you do still have 15 points worth of animal blood in the house from your herd.
I just feel myself and start up slicing their body.
No, we agreed that they had to be alive while you did that. Mm-hmm. Remember?
Yep.
Alright, so I just take their ears for making a trophy or something.
Okay. By the way, you can add these as Mortal Combatant kills, I think.
Yep.
Even so if it is a cutscene.
We'll go over... Oh wait, I just got a kill.
Actually, no. Yeah, that would be a civilian, more like, because the pilot would not be a combat
Probably,
character.
That is right.
Yes.
I do got 1.
Yes,
you got on the board.
You are on the board.
Well, once I see that, once I notice that John is ready, or is done, I'll go over to greetings, and in the chopper.
I will go and get a radio from one of the guys that I heard talking.
Okay. You pick up a radio.
Headquarters, dispatch, you there?
What did I call him, Jim? Yes, yeah. Jim, what's going on?
This was the wrong bus. We're gonna take the search further to the west. It looks like they might have gone that way.
I see. Crap. The tech guy said they fixed that problem. Jesus Christ. Seriously?
Yeah. I know, it sucks. God damn it.
I'll tell them to expect a visit from you when you get back. That'll put the fear of God into those fuckers. Anyway, yes. Have a good one, Jim.
You too. I'm presuming my good judge of character would have actually counted on that one, by the way, so...
Yeah, you succeed at that. Unless you should probably get rid of the GPS, possibly send it to the west, though, because if they find it pointing to here again after they check for more faults...
Yep.
Yeah. I'll be checking the chopper for GPS, anything that can be... anything technology related that could be used to actually to find the location of the helicopter.
Okay.
You drive the bus.
And I remove it from the helicopter in a manner that does not trigger any alarms.
Okay, great.
Okay.
What kind of roll is that?
Roll your perception technology to discover SD magic aimed at fucking you. Nobody forced him.
Backup.
It's a good thing I invested in this. Any difficulty modifiers?
Well, do you think there should be any?
I don't think so.
How hard do you want to try?
Like.
Okay, let's put this way. If you want to make a really quick search, it will be an 8. If you take your time and go over it, essentially taking 1.5 to 2 hours, then it will be at 6.
But you will be taking the risk that they might ping the location.
Can I take 30 minutes to do that?
As opposed to 5 minutes, I guess that would be a 7 then.
Yes.
I recommended willpower point.
The chopper appears to be an older model from the 80s relegated to, you know, these country police officers. So it doesn't appear to have any tracking. You're good.
Just to be sure.
No, you think you would have found it.
Hey, greetings. Why don't you check if there's anyone in the force that might want to check after his chopper?
Has greetings stayed around here? It's half an hour later.
He actually is messing around with the various guns and tasers right now.
But there are 2 heavy revolvers.
And some tasers, right?
And two tasers and 2 nightsticks as well.
Sweet. I found my new gun.
You may add the weaponry to the group inventory. If you do not, then we're going to assume that it got dumped to the bus or thereabouts. And John did say that he was driving the bus off a distance towards the west, I believe you said?
Yep.
Yeah.
So go ahead and make the roll. What did we make Jackalow roll at 7?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 7.
Okay, then make a dexterity drive roll at 7.
Let me roll it. Just wait.
That's really nightsticks.
You know, this is why I wanted to start playing as soon as possible, because you create ways for me to create a story.
It's going great.
Statewide manhunt for the cop killer student guy. Okay, there's some difficulty in doing this, but an hour later you do manage to drive the bus to the next town over, and you may now go looking for a way to get back.
Have fun.
Actually,
a car.
Roll me 1d10. 3 or below is badness.
10 is goodness.
Okay. As you're looking for a car to steal, you hear faintly coming from an alleyway two voices talking. You hear one of them talking about the masquerade and how if this young fuck is as careless again, he might just be left out for the sun. Oh no, this is a Camarilla town.
Well, fuck!
You can attempt to murder both of them.
Yes! Yes! I even have Camarilla vampires, fairly strong ones, copied over already, so that's fine! I am ready for this.
By the way, what's the city name?
It's not Springfield. Let's say it's Fairview. Nobody cares. Generic city name insert.
I will try to...
I think we said Toluca.
No, the other one where John is at. Actually, roll me perception alertness at 9. You hear nothing.
Which reminds me, something I need to do. I'm fine.
What are you rolling for? The blood thing?
Yep. Yeah.
Given that you drained essentially 6 from him, that would be at a higher difficulty, I believe. Especially considering that he died as a result.
It doesn't really matter about dying. It matters if I drain him.
Let me look up the exact wording on it, because I think it might have scaled a bit more than a yes-no thing.
No, it goes from 6 to 9. But that's only if you drain him. Which is why I specified I killed him.
Give me the page, will you?
Okay, let's go grab it.
Just because... Not that I want to create an amazing amount of fuckery here with this, because... That's a boring way to create fuckery. I prefer to exploit your own mistakes, but... I would like to, since it's a major flaw and, you know...
Sanctuary Animism, page 300.
300, you say?
Bottom right.
There we go. Yep, it does look like it's a 6. Or, actually, no. 9 if she drains the mortal to the point of death. Namely, if they die.
I did it right before really dying, is what I was trying to say. Did that make sense? Which is why I didn't do 10. AKA, he died, but couldn't do anything about it.
How would I want to handle this? I'm tempted to make you have 2 less blood points in your system in that case, if you left him to slowly die.
That's fine.
I would let you get away with this on 4, and if that's your intention to deliberately do it like that, then that's fine.
Yeah, that was my intention, completely.
Alright. So, I guess we should start wrapping up. John, how do you intend to get back? Just steal a car?
Yeah.
I will use my Malkavian powers to try and see if there's any way to get to stop them from searching for this plane.
Wait, actually...
The helicopter. This flying machine.
Does Greeting or Alexander have a cell phone?
You never asked for their numbers. You never exchanged contact information, so you, even if they do, you don't know... how to call them.
That's right.
I just see a ship-looking car.
Okay, give me a perception alertness and a dex larceny. Perception alertness was at 8, because you're looking for technological crap. Okay, in this case, you bypass 2 cars with very dangerous-looking alarms and manage to settle on a 3rd. Roll your dex larceny to get into it. Okay, the car is now yours. You have claimed the car. And make sure to add the pineapple mobile to the group holdings as well.
That's a good one.
Ah, yes. Yes, it is. Excellent. And tasers would be two unless you took one for yourself.
I did take one for myself.
Le gasp. Okay, and essentially, you would have three walkie-talkies on top of the radio that's built into the helicopter. Just in case it ever comes up.
So, yeah. Rolling Malkavian Eyes of Chaos. What difficulty?
To see if something could horribly fuck you here.
Yeah.
I think 7 will do. You can adjust it down to 6.
Alright. Complete success!
Okay, you hear a little thrill from one of the cops and then from the others. Apparently the cell phones are telling you that they're gonna betray you any second now! Smartphones are apparently dicks.
Okay, so... I know what we need to do here. He goes, takes out the smartphones, puts them into the helicopter, comes back out. Can anyone try and drive this thing?
I would rather not.
Let's get this out of here.
I would say to try to drive a flying machine, I would probably require a minimum of drive 3.
That's kind of what I figured. And the only one with drive 2 is that guy. Look, who's good at this? Who's really good at this?
Now, John, keeping in mind that you're just heading back to Toluca. You are not currently on the site.
Yep. Alex, are you good at this? We need to get this out of here.
I wouldn't be able to drive it anywhere.
This is when you go to the other pack, promise a major boon, and ask to borrow the Vos to carry the helicopter away.
All right. In that case, help me lift it.
I can't do that.
We have blood. Get the blood, buff up, we lift it, put it in onto a vehicle, drive away.
You only have the van, and there's no convenient way to lift it up there, I would think. It's not much the weight as much as it is having something to stand on so you can lift it. You'd have to actually create some sort of a gantry.
Nope. We'll be good. We can lift it.
I just don't carry just the phones.
What is the strength 6 thing?
I think that's throwing a motorcycle.
I would say that you would be able to lift it between the two of you. It's just that... It's the positioning that's a bitch, I would say.
If we don't care about harming it, we can just angle it onto it.
Sure. Well, you just...
So we have a ton of blood anyway, so... What we spend... All the animal blood and the blood in the cops.
Basically, that's what we're doing, yes.
Yeah. Does anyone have any craft?
I do.
How much?
I think I got one or two. I don't remember. Satan, give me your sheet. I have craft of 1.
And you don't really have that many wits either to lash it down. You know, I would let you roll.
Sure.
At difficulty 8, probably, for this kind of improvised thing.
It's really improvised, and the only thing we're trying to do is get it away from here.
Okay, it looks good.
Looks good.
You have it lashed down good.
Yep.
Okay, so... You lash it down, that takes another half an hour. The pilot is dumped on the ground. Very much dead at this point. Would you like to do anything else before you drive off?
Yes. Not driving this myself. We're just sending it. We're just going to get it over to the lake and then send it in there.
You could have had a helicopter, you fool.
Nope.
Yes, if I actually succeeded my technology, my perception technology role.
I see so, how yeah, it is.
That's what's going on.
You know, that's fine. That's fine.
They're going to have questions, of course. Why exactly the helicopter was on top of a pineapple truck, for example. But...
Well, clearly they were having a chase scene and they were landing on there to intercept the fucker, right? Lean down through the window and shoot him.
And they still think it's a single person.
The good news is, this will get them off our back, more or less. There's going to be, of course, searches nearby, but...
Of course.
There won't be any real evidence of stuff going on. As long as you take care of those bodies, goddammit.
Yes.
Let me add another line. Strikes to hunters.
Couldn't we turn them into
vampires? Order. Yes. Ghouls? No. They're dead.
Yeah, I mean,
You're the doctors. Make a call.
Shovelhead. I think we should turn into shovelheads.
Why? Who are we sending them against?
You know, for security. So that in case we get ambushed.
You do not use shovelheads for security.
They're shovelheads.
Well, what else do we use right now? We don't have much else for security.
You find something else. We make ghouls. We are vampires.
I know.
Don't make other vampires for simple security. You do it if you're going to war or something, but...
Yeah, you turn them into a vampire, they have valuable skill, like being able to fly a chopper.
Too late. Nope. Besides, it takes longer than just putting your blood in it. A little bit longer, true, but still.
It's going to be another hour for them to waken up, or possibly as little as 15 minutes.
Yep.
Let's go with that. Let's say that it's between 15 minutes and an hour.
And it's just random.
Yes, exactly. So you wouldn't know. They would be in the back of the pineapple truck going crazy and throwing pineapples at you while you try to balance the chopper on front of it. On top of it, that is.
So yeah, are we basically done with this part? It was more of a cutscene than anything. So.
Yeah.
I do want one more roll since you failed at lashing it down.
What do you see there? All right. In the chopper as well.
Yes, you can pile the bodies in the back of the pineapple truck if you want.
I already threw a couple of them, and the ones with the cell phones, into the chopper before we put it up there.
Ah, yes.
Sure, we can just throw the pilot there as well after I drained him.
Alright. What roll do you want?
I want a roll from Alexander, because you did not lash it down securely.
Mm-hmm.
So... I would like a dexterity drive roll at 9, I think, as you at some point will realize that the chopper is starting to slide and unbalance the whole thing.
Dexterity drive.
Yes.
Great. Yes. But don't worry.
If he was smart, he would have buffed.
He didn't state it, did he? Son of a god.
Yes, he didn't.
We had all this blood. And we
I was planning on spending. We did say that we would be spending a ton of blood just to get the strength up.
Yeah.
Yes, but you did not say about dexterity. Would you like to spend another destiny point to retcon that?
No.
When I noticed, I can still spend at least one blood point.
Just spend a willpower point.
Okay, I'll be spending a willpower point.
And roll for it.
That's right. Spend it when it's important. We got a success. Yay. That should be good enough to get to where we need it.
Okay, as you're driving past the bridge, you just drive into the water here, and the whole thing sinks into the canal. Possibly leaving it so that on a clear day, it can actually be seen from the bridge.
Yep.
With one success, that seems appropriate.
Yes.
Apparently that...
Now scream out of the goddamn thing.
Apparently that one turn was a bitch.
Yep. Alright, time to go back.
Yes.
Okay, both of you reek of filth, as the river is apparently very polluted.
Yep.
It's a good thing we have showers.
Okay, so you appear to have cleaned up the fuck up. Congratulations.
It was great.
Well, we're better off if we spend the things rather than never spend them at all.
That's kind of the idea, yep.
Actually, I realized that I need to add several strike lines for more, at least one more, namely for the FBI. Strikes yep. to raid, strikes to hunter. Well, actually, that should be Camarilla raid. Because... And keep in mind, these might at some point be picked up by one of the other packs as well.
Absolutely. That's how this works.
Yep.
So, as sometime later, John arrives and the helicopter and the pineapple truck are gone, leaving you with one dingy car, you can gather together, discuss, and decide how much experience you have gained. So, what have we learned, starting with Alexander?
I have learned that some mortals are incredibly stupid and think that candy is good for your health.
Okay, mortals are also dumb.
Mortals are pretty... mortals can be surprisingly resilient. When you're fighting them.
You know, I will ask you to pick one or the other. Because I think when you try to mix several ones into a single lesson, it kind of detracts from the impact of that lesson on the character.
Okay, I'll be taking the latter one.
Namely, the mortals can be surprisingly resilient when you're trying to kill them.
Yes. Good.
John, what have you learned?
Some occasions are actually sane for people.
Ish.
Yeah. And know how to scare mortals. That's very good.
Okay. Malkavians are actually people too. Racist fuck. So, greetings. What have we learned?
I have learned today actually quite a bit. You know what? Greetings learned a lot today.
Mm-hmm.
Who John is. Who Alexander is. Who the Ductus is.
Pick a thing that stands out the most.
Stands out the most?
Or that impacts your character the most, rather. That he would...
the character the most. Okay. In that case, it would be... Honestly, it would probably be that Toby is not only a tool, but a flawed one. For he can't even take anything being said to him. Not initially, at least.
Okay.
Everything else was just good fun.
You just wait till he comes in with an assault rifle in each hand riding a Vost. You just wait. Can you imagine it?
Those dual-wielding penalties? Oh, and remember the other penalties as well. Oh, and you're shooting yourself and the boss now.
You know, he might be able to manage it.
He has ambidextrous. Only takes a plus one on the one in his offhand.
I think it was that you... Yeah, offhand doesn't take any penalties with ambidextrous. I think it was just a plus one in V20 on the offhand.
Yeah, I thought that's what I just said.
Okay, so moments of awesomeness and badassery. Any recommendations?
Can I just say I awesome Malkavian stuff?
I would say that way you dealt with the ghoul listening in would be a potential moment for that. Yes.
Yeah, it was a nice moment.
I don't have anything else to say. I don't disagree with it, so.
That pineapple truck, it's sliding! I'm losing control! Help! Help!
He's a good ghoul.
Alright, so I believe the Malkavian gets the extra experience point, and the other two get three. Is there anything you want to spend experience on in between this session and the last? Or the next, rather. Last, as if I'm gonna kill you this quickly, you get to suffer.
Alright, so that's three experience points, right?
For you, it's four.
Ah, sweet.
Because I'm giving you the extra four. What you did to poor Darnell.
Poor Darnell. He didn't know what was coming to him.
He just wanted to understand these monsters he's trapped with.
It's great.
And now his dead mother is yelling at him again. Poor fucker.
Very poor fucker. Where was experience expenditures? Because I actually want to look at virtues and stuff.
Virtues are two per.
Two per? That's what I thought they were. Why can't I find it? Experience. There we go.
Yes, it's current level times two. And who is doing that with the maracas over there? Bacon, I'm looking at you.
What?
What maracas?
I hear someone shaking something. Or mosquitoes or something, I don't know.
Or scratching.
Or scratching. Something, yeah.
I may or may not play online shooting games, but not maracas.
Yeah, that's not what we're hearing. Don't worry about that.
I don't hear anything, so...
It's him again!
What?
You do know that I'm gonna copy Trogdor's template over, right?
Yes.
Maybe that's why you couldn't succeed at summoning him, because he was already here.
Or maybe he was already dead.
Silly peasant, Trogdor can't die!
What do I get for killing Trogdor?
You get bragging rights, except no one would ever believe you. Because Trogdor can't die.
What if you put his head on a stick and put it in the front yard?
Trogdor is made of dreams and unicorn tears, so he would just dissolve into those.
I wonder, are there any rituals that require unicorn tears? Epic.
Specifically? No.
There is, however, a ritual that is spoken of in legends about... Well, it's one that allows you to kill dragons. It is made up of three mysterious steps, which are symbolized by a figure that is wearing short pants, has swiggly stink lines coming off of him, and depicts that figure as being on fire. No one has been able to interpret these, but apparently it has something to do with killing dragons.
Oh, you.
But apparently it requires a Methuselah's level of power to make any real attempt of it.
I'll just keep my experience for now. Let's get that obfuscate up to two.
Can you imagine Salute in short pants covered in shit? And slightly on fire battling Trogdor with his fortitude. I laugh at your fire breath dragon. I'm already on fire.
Alright. So, we're done for now, I think.
Yes, I believe we're done. One last question. How much downtime do you want to have before next session? And is there anything you want to do in a downtime?
Specifically, I think just a couple days to justify all of us setting up all the starting stuff. Then we'll begin trying to find out the location of the other pack.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
I do like on my downtime to set up a small shack near the river where I can just torture people to death.
You want to set up a shack? How are you going to go about it not having any money? Actually, I think that should be role-played out.
I do think that should be role-played out, because yes, I was just saying a couple days to justify all the stuff we
said we are getting already.
The pooled backgrounds.
Yeah,
for now, you can have essentially the butcher's guys report anything strange they see around here. And that can function as your security.
Sure. I mean, it's very wide open and everything, so just even that is pretty justifiable with 3 points.
Mm-hmm. And then we can wrap up here. I'm gonna stop the recording.